Hello, hello. 4CJ here. About to, I haven't flown the 787 in a really long time. They just kicked in a, they just got a new update today. That includes CPDLC. I got that configured. I'm not going to use it today. But I just want to get, familiarized again with this aircraft. Every once in a while, I'll fly once, see how it goes, and then go from there. Alrighty, so let's go to flight plan has been filed. It's going to be a short flight from La Paz to Cochabamba to probably do the VOR approach. Alright, we are good on there. We're at Sierra Lima, Lima Papa. Looking good. Now let's do a route request. Wait, you know what? Let me try something else that's also fairly new. And we'll see if that's gonna work. For the 787, I have tested another aircraft. Alright, we get that. We can unload that, import from SimBrief. There you are. Alright, now we'll try to export to the aircraft. Let's see if magic happens. Looks like it did. Showing up on there. Alright, I don't need you anymore. It's not showing on here though. Alright, let's keep going. Papa. To Sierra Lima, Charlie Bravo. Controller sent me the weather info. We have 280 at 6, plus 10 plus NSC 10, negative 4, 1037. So 1037. Go, 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 go. How you doing, man? 1037. Alright, 280, so that's gonna give us runway 28. Easy peasy. Straight down the runway, and let's do. We are going to be Golf Foxtrot Alpha for Charlie Juliet, and I'm going to go ahead and do a route request. Hopefully, it's going to pull up. Let me get that out of the way on a route page. Cool. We'll load that and execute. Erase the runway. I might dance Cochabamba. Maybe, maybe. Okay, let's see what we got here. What do we got? I know some of these stuff is not up yet. We're dry. Wind is 280 at 6. So 280. Oops. 280 at 6. Temperature 10. And a QNH. Ah, it's correct. It's already on there. Let me try to put it hectopascals. There you go. Takeoff weight. We're working with, let's see, 359028. Are we doing, is it on pounds? Make sure this is pounds. Yes, okay, cool. Three, five, niner. And a zero fuel weight of 340. Optimum. Should give us this, right? Optimum, yes. I'm gonna do off and none. So let's try that. Three, seven, four, one, four, five. Derated takeoff 2. Select temperature 22. VRF 3141. Let's. At the moment in full. You know what, I'm just gonna put it manually. 359er. Our reserve is 4.2. Cost index 66. Giving it 2, right? There we go. Select 2, climb 2, and a select off. What was it? It was showing on here. Where is it? I erased it. And 340. It can't be right. Ah, it is, okay. So select is at 70 for the derated. Derated takeoff 2. Okay, 374145. Flaps 5, CG, it's not showing the CG, I don't know, I'm just going to throw in a number. Dang it. For 11.228 for, all right, let me edit. This is wrong though. This. right, block is 19. Already get it on there. Payload 52. Should give us ballpark 360 and 359. I'm okay with that. Still giving us a high number here. Let's go back. Reserves 4.2, cost index 66, cruising CG 6, gross. That's a little bit higher, but that's okay. Alright, let's try again. I don't know why it's giving me that high of a number. Change it to 2. Is it the rate of 2 still? Yes. 374145. I'll leave it at 362. Yeah, alright, 35, 39, 48. It's close enough. Flips 5. Alright, CG. Alright, what do we put here? Awesome. That'll do for now. Let's see. Departure. Gecko 1 Bravo. And that's all. 4928. Let's look at. Flight level 250. Okay. Yeah, I can do 250. Flight level 250. I'll change that on here. Cool. We'll do 250. interpreter need? I don't know. I didn't. First officer is checking that. I didn't. I need to check. Let's look outside. Do you know where it is? Can you show me where it is? I need to see. Who knows? Oh, that's the other thing I was gonna do. I need to configure this thing. My cockpit wheel. There we go. I'll keep it like that. Alrighty, runway heading is 278. We'll leave it at auto. 278. Go the other way. Actually, let me deal with the buttons here. Claudia, welcome. 278. Welcome. Alright, what were the takeoff speeds? 48 plus 5, let's do 53. And our initial climb. Let's look at the SID. SID is giving us 200. I just set 200 for the time being. LNAV. Flight directors are coming on. LNAV, VNAV. We're gonna do auto throttle. I'm not using no. It's very not me. Not okay. So MCP is taken care of. Takeoff speed is taken care of. CDU pre-flight is completed. Trim was let's see, 9.5. So let's do flight controls. There's our 9.5 set. Okay, and taxi takeoff briefing, beacon is coming on. Let's make sure our APU is running. Maybe not. Should show in here as well. There it is, RPM 0, it's not running. Alright. Mr. APU, start. There we go. It's pulling up. And I do have the sound mod for this aircraft, so it should be pretty cool. Let me look at the cameras. It's a good camera. Awesome, man. What else you got? All right, awesome. Alright, APU is feeding it. Let's turn off our external power. Zero on a center tank. All right, cool. Let's do this. That was our before start. Cool. All right, let's ask for pushback, but before, let's get our clearance. Go nowhere. Oh, it disconnected. Did it disconnect? It's gone. Let's see. Might be having connection problems here. I'm refreshing here. It's showing online. Let's try to call him up. Maybe it's not showing for me. 128 to smoke 2. Put the transponder on here. Let's do 2000. Get that out of the way. Hopefully he'll come back. Let's see.
Cockpit to ground.
Should have an accident. It's the...
This is the ground. Just standing by.
Downstairs.
Okay, sir. The bypass pin is installed. All doors and hatches closed, and all ground equipment is removed.
The parking brakes are set. You may lift.
Parking brakes set. Lifting the aircraft. Standing by for push.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
We are cleared for start and push.
Okay, clear for push and start. Please release parking brakes.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback. You can start the engines in the sequence.
Alright, sounds good.
Yeah, we'll start in the sequence.
And with 787, he can do all at once. The fly model, you know, the engine does the
Okay, pushback completed. Please set your parking brakes.
Ground, you may disconnect.
Okay, sir. Clearance to disconnect.
Auto. RTO. Flight controls. Full left. Neutral. Full right. right. Neutral. Neutral. Down. Neutral. Right rudder. Left rudder. Alright, ground equipment is clear. And we're shutting down the APU. So before taxi is complete, and flaps 5. Side. I'll leave that here. And let's go back to ND. Brakes released. At the Rolls Royce. Seem to be getting tether wheel. We'll do another test here. It's unresponsive. There you go. Just reset. Lot of traffic. Gulf Air 4, Charlie Juliet is taxiing to Holding Point runway 28. 13,000 feet available to us. Plenty of runway, 4,000 meters. High altitude, so. A lot of traffic, Gulf Air Fort Charles just lining up runway to it. I always have a hard time at this airport in this part because it's good. You're going uphill. So we need to add a little bit more of power. Alright, we did before takeoff, so we're good to go. Let's do 50%. And it's stable. Toga. Brakes release. We look at 35, 39, and 48. Airspeed is alive. Slowly picking up speed. There's 80 knots. To do better than that. Slowly creeping up. 35. Or not. God. Nose is not going up. Real quick. Let's do a... I don't know why, though. So, reset. Nothing happened. I was pulling all the way back. You know what? Let's fly something else. Fly the A300. I know, it's crazy. I was pulling all the way back and nothing. Would not be Gold Fair though, so I need to, okay, while that's loading, let me go ahead and do the changes here. Let's do, I'm gonna keep it simple. What is, Postman? Bravo Charlie Sierra. And I think they're a PW. Alright, so that was a test flight. I do every once in a while. Let's do... Yeah, at least this one I know. It's solid. It works solid. Might be me, I don't know. It's actually PW. Right? There it is, PW. PW Cargo. We're gonna do this one. Same thing. And my setup is gonna be a lot faster. Or I'll put it... Maybe the cargo terminal. I'll just put it back there. Yeah, that's military cargo. What is there? GA. That's military. Maybe down here. Yeah, I'll just put it on there. Alright, fine. Alright, Bravo Charlie Sierra, 4 Charlie Juliet, same thing. And let's do auto. Yeah, keep auto. And go back out. I did test the PDLC on the A300 and it works really, really good. It's solid. Let's do 250. Alright, refiled. Alright, awesome. I promise this is going to be a lot faster. Alright, let's do this. Batteries on. We have external power available, so gonna get it turned on. Get at least coming on. See those signs coming on. Non smoking auto. Let's align. Strobe's going to auto. So let the logo on these three guys. Actually, squib and loop. Awesome. Engine one. Engine two. Flight plan. Align IRS. Bravo Charlie Sierra, 4 Charlie Juliet, 6 gonna go in there. I'm gonna fly 250. Bus index is 66. considering doing CTP with this aircraft, or the, between three aircraft, actually. PMDG comes out with a 777. Also, BBJ, or this aircraft. Alright, let me get my checklist. Put the numbers in as well. Flight plan's gonna go to right side, and I need 0.2 down. 21.7. 0.28 is 2.726. And a CG. Tail to the left. It is buggy. Start up two, let's go ahead and start another one. Stabilizing. Good start at one. Continuous three lights. Let's do runway turn off. Taxi. We'll deploy these, extend them. Oops. APU's coming off. Arm. Flaps are 15, 15. Two notches. Hello, the traffic. Postman for Teljanus, taxiing the apron and Bravo 14328. After start, ignition is continuous three light, ABU bleed is off, master is off, NEI is not required, speed brakes armed, rudder trim set to zero, slats and flaps 15, 15, and trim is set as 0.2 down. Taxi. Brakes release. Takeoff down to line, flight controls. Check that now. Full left. Full right. Up. Down. Right rudder. Left rudder. Briefing confirms slats flaps 15-15, performance on FMAs 56, 56, and 61. Takeoff config is checked, normal. Just double check again. Awesome. Nose lights to takeoff. Strobes. Traffic, postman for Charlie Juno that is lining up runway 28. For takeoff down to line is complete. Below the line, cabin is secure. TCAS DRA, weather radar is coming on. Gonna do a PAXOFF departure. Ignition. Continuous relight and NES is off. Before takeoff checklist below the line is complete. Toga. I was putting full power in a 787 and it wasn't. This is a lot better. What happens, so the we looked at the manual for this aircraft. What happens is the cabin altitude is going to go down and then it's going to go back up, so it's kind of catch up with what is normal. We took off at 13,000 some feet, so it's showing up right now, but it will go back to normal. Get the climb out at 250. Figure it out to rank first. Still going down. They're getting over 2,000 per minute. Change for 12 miles. For the TCAS. And I need to go ahead, and it's a short flight, so I'm going to go ahead and program our arrival. It's going to be the VOR. Favoring 1-4. Keep to climb out to 20, what is that, 250? You are Zulu runway 14. Ailet. And none. We won't need that. So it's clear that out. And we'll clear that out as well. There we go. Sorry, 8950. Speed's going to be 136. Let's do a 5 degree 30-40 for the flaps. So that's giving us 140 knots. And our elevation over there is 8354. So let's do 8400. 12-1 is the VOR. And we're first going to fly to inbound 065. Actually, I'm going to set the approach moment VOR on both. Fly direct to from TDOT's payload. Take the payload's mandatory 17,000. Now fly inbound on a 065 to 9 DME. Now make a left turn. We'll maintain the 7 DME arc. Then on 305, we'll make a right turn to intercept. Now we'll go visual from here. 12.1 is the frequency. And if you go missed, we climb on a 142, direct forking and hold inbound on a 322. MSA over Charlie Bravo Alpha, 15.6, 17, 18.5, and 17. What else you got? MSA to 950, and let's see what else we got here. At an angle of 3.43 at 140 knots, 850 feet per minute. So we can do 900 feet per minute down to 9,000. Pretty much land on 1-4 and then clear of either Gulf or the intersecting. Actually, on this aircraft, might be able to clear Charlie. And there's that. All right, let's spin. I always love flying in Bolivia. It's challenging. Once 7,000 from 25, that's 8,000. So about 24 miles. Let's do 30 miles. And make sure the altitudes are good. So I'm going to look at... Let's see if we'll be able to see it here. To wait. which amount of traffic will spend for challenging it. It's 50 miles from Haylut, inbound for the EOR to runway 14. Gear down. Stay within 7. To adjust the heading. 6.8. And to send out the 10.5. So 10,000.
Thank you.
Well, unfortunately, just I've seen the Foxtrot from lane 05 and Pro Bravo to the Camp Cargo here on Cochabamba. Thank you. All right, guys, welcome to Cochabamba. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for sticking around. Let's go.